Hello everyone, welcome to Robocodex, and today we're going to be breaking down how to build the ultimate robot for first LEGO leap. Specifically today, we're going to be focusing on the robot design, but we'll also be giving you tips on how to succeed in first LEGO League and how to make your first LEGO League team the best it can be. Let's get started. Robot design is a crucial step to succeeding in first LEGO League competitions. Here are some tips to help you create the best robot possible. Thoroughly understand the rules and break down to your team, or if you're a team member watching this video, deeply understand everything that the rules state. Obviously, sometimes throughout the year, there are changes to the rules, but try to understand the rules. And if there's any little bit of uncertainty in your mind and you've read the rules, knowing what your robot needs to accomplish will make sure that your robot design aligns with the competition's goals. Number two, a modular design. Design your robot with modularity in mind, allowing for changes or tweaks throughout the season so that your robot isn't at its same state throughout the whole season. Because obviously no robot is perfect, and that's why FLL gives you a whole year to get better. And you might say, well, they haven't unleashed the season and there's obviously an off-season time. Well, in this off-season, you can look through different types of robot designs and build on them and see what's good in each different one. Because obviously, the majority of robots that win championships, it isn't within the actual robot design, if you get what I'm saying. It's within the attachments and how they fit the robot. Utilizing interchangeable components such as attachments, sensors, and motors will help you see what works in specific robot designs or in that specific time or that specific test or draft that you made. It'll help you see what works and what doesn't so that you can build your robot a little bit every single time. Number three, efficiency of motors. Prioritize tasks and efficacy and allocate your motors so that the motors are as efficient as possible. Experiment with gearing systems, attachments, as well as passive attachments so that you can ensure that your robot's motors are being used efficiently, as there is a limit on how many motors you can have on a Spike Prime robot. Number four, sturdy construction. Not only the season, but also the competition. When the stress is high in a competition, it will make people on your team to cause mistakes, or even you to make mistakes, dropping the robot and maybe breaking it or breaking specific pieces. This is why modularity is important, and also the sturdiness of your robot. If your robot's modular, you can obviously change the parts out quickly without wasting that much time, of course. And also, if your robot is sturdy, you can avoid that completely because the robot will have minimum damage when it falls. Number five, testing and iteration. Test your robot as much as you possibly can. This will help you see areas for growth and opportunities for your team to grow. And when I say test your robot a lot, is I want you guys to be collecting data on the efficiency of certain attachments or motors in your robot design. So every time your robot goes out for a mission or to complete a run, you see what worked and what didn't, and then you can build on that. Even if you're not changing your robot every single day, have those notes saved somewhere, and even better, in your robot executive summary, so that the referees or judges can see that you actually made progress and changes and grew throughout the season. Something that I have mentioned before and will mention again is test completely different robot designs. This is why I feel like the off season is one of the most important times, because it's time where you can take advantage of other teams maybe not having as much focus on robotics in this moment. In the summer, most teams do not meet up on a regular basis, and if your team is meeting up or even working on their skills at home, it will give you a massive advantage. and testing different robot designs in this time, I feel is the perfect time to do so, because you can see what works and what doesn't without that much of a time crunch pressure. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Leave a comment with your thoughts and questions. Obviously, making these videos aren't free, but I really love doing it. Thanks for watching, and best of luck on your first Lego League journey.